goal of the mini excavator development plan was to give customers new features that they valued. So we spent over 3 years developing these new excavators, trying to understand what customers wanted in an excavator. And that's why we came up with industry first features, more performance, and lower owning and operating costs.
Talking about those key features of the new machines, can you name some of them?
Yeah, so we're launching 1 to 2 metric ton size machines and 7 to 10 ton size machines. On the 1 to 2 ton size machines, we have 4 industry first features. One is stick steer steering control. So stick steer is when you can operate the machine using your left hand joystick to drive the machine or operate the machine instead of using the levers. That's a very big one. The second one is cruise control. So with that stick steer steering, you can push it forward and you can select the speed and actually let go of the joystick or keep your hand just close to the joystick, and it will allow you to not have to keep pushing forward like you would on levers or even on the lever, on the travel lever. The third one for this machine, this size machine, 1 to 2 ton, is air conditioning inside the cab. There are no other manufacturers that offer air conditioning on a 1.5 to 2 ton size machine. So this is a big industry first feature that's never been done before. And then the last one is we have a full color LCD monitor inside the cab. So if you look at 1 to 2 ton size machines, this sort of functionality and the ability to change settings in the machine and really make it perfect for the operator and what he wants to do, that is an industry first feature. Now, on 7 to 10 ton, there are a couple of other things. We've got the stick steer, we've got the cruise control, we've got an LCD full color monitor, but that will also will have a touch screen option. And then the last one is we have a high flow option. And the high flow option is basically a dedicated pump and dedicated auxiliary pump for hydromechanical tools.
One important aspect is what you call parts commonality. What is it and what's the effect of it?
Yeah, so one of the things that we said when we designed the product was we wanted to lower the owning and operating costs for our customers. Many customers told us that they were worried about damage and parts repair costs and those types of things, whether they were a rental customer or someone that owned their own machine. So what we said was we want the 1 to 2 ton range, we want the doors and the panels and the parts to be as common as possible. So many of the parts are shared between the machines. Even the side door panels, many of them are shared. So someone that has a 1 to 2 ton size machine, if they have varying sizes, they can have the same panels on those machines. On the 7 to 10 ton, we did the same thing. Many people said they wanted parts replacement costs to go down. So we made sure that we made the panels on the 7.5, 8, 9, and 10 ton size machines all the same size. So if you wanted to replace one, they would be very, very common. And then we also lowered the price on those items as well.
You already mentioned the high flow. Can you give some details about what can you use it for?
Yeah, so with excavators becoming so very popular across the world, it's becoming the most preferred way to move dirt around the world. People are using excavators for more activities and more applications. We see many more people using brush cutters and mulchers specifically on excavators, but other tools as well. A high flow work tool such as a brush cutter or a mulcher, you want to have a dedicated flow to that tool. For example, if you have to share flow, when you travel an excavator, it takes flow. When you swing an excavator, it takes flow. When you move your bucket and your stick, it takes flow. With this new design, we've got a dedicated pump for auxiliary. So if you put a mulcher or brush cutter and you are spinning a mulcher or brush cutting head and trying to cut vegetation, you would keep your constant flow there even if you traveled or moved the machine, which is a big improvement versus previous machines and also competitive machines. It will do very, very good work with that.
When you're talking about bringing more value to the customer, you would need to know what the customer actually needs. So how do you do that?
We spent 3 years in this process, and one thing we said from the very beginning was we wanted to bring some innovation, but we wanted to know what customers wanted. So we spent time with dozens of customers. So in the 3 years, we went through many different phases of the new product introduction. one of the first phases was getting the voice of the customer. So we brought customers in from around the world and we asked them, what do you want to see? What does the current machine, ours or competitors, not do that you want it to do? And when we had that information, we started designing. And then after we started designing, we had a prototype. And then we brought, in many cases, some of the same customers back and said, now, what do you see? What do you like? What would you like to see different? And then we changed the product again to make it even better. And then at the end, we sent those machines out to customers when we had the final design. Some of the same customers that were involved in the very beginning also were involved in the field follow program, where we put it out with customers for thousands of hours to see how the machine acted, how it responded, and so to make sure that we had done everything that the customer had wanted us to do. So a long process, but probably the most extensive that we've ever done. Very, very detailed, many thousands of hours on the machines, dozens of customers around the world to give us input on what they wanted. And the good news is, now that we've launched it to the public and now that we're launching it, the feedback on these industry first features, on the lower owning operating costs, and also the increases in performance that we didn't even talk about, all those things are really resonating with the customer.
Can you name one feature which has turned out to be the most popular?
They're all very popular. I would say on the small excavators, the 1 to 2 ton size machine, we incorporated a tilt up cab. And no one else in the 1 to 2 ton size class is utilizing that as it stands now. So that is a really big one. I'm going to give you three, actually. On the larger machines, the idea of high flow on a larger machine is allows you to be higher performance with those hydromechanical work tools. And then the third one, universally across 1 to 2 ton and 7 to 10 ton, the stick steer option is one that has really hit home with a lot of customers. And when we've had press or customers or dealers, when they get on that machine, they go, wow, why has no one ever thought of this before? So the idea of stick steer on these machines is something that I believe, and I think we believe collectively, is gonna be very, very big for the industry overall. And I think a lot of people are gonna want it.